Do you think the government should be concerned about bullying in schools and around villages or towns? People do feel unsafe and, you know, it's not very nice to get picked on. Any views on this?
Yes. I'll go first if you want. As a school governor, one of the key fundamentals I believe every young person has, and I believe any person in society has, is the right to feel safe in the environment that they're currently in. And obviously the school environment is the critical environment for most young people, because it's the element of time that they're away from their family and they're learning. And if you're in an environment that you're not happy with, you really will not perform to the best of your abilities. And I would suggest it's incumbent on us all to make sure that that environment is as safe and as secure as possible. I sit on the Enterprise and Learning Committee in the Assembly here, and one of the issues we have been addressing over the last 3 to 4 weeks has been the school learner transport measure that's currently going through. And one of the key issues about school transport is the bullying aspect that many have faced, sadly, on the buses that take them to school. And one of the simple ways that that could be addressed would be the inclusion of CCTV on the buses. We had an example of a young pupil who was attending Caldecott Primary, Caldecott Comprehensive School, and he said once CCTV was put on the school buses, the bullying element stopped like that, because people suddenly felt accountable, their actions was on tape. And so we can address it by simple measures. It's just having the courage to face up to it. And we as politicians must address that, because if young people and any person in society feels that they are vulnerable, they will feel alienated, they will close in on themselves, and they won't release their full potential.
I agree totally with the points that Andrew just raised, but there's a question here as well, as in what's the government's role in terms of helping children in the school environment? I would say it's the government's role to facilitate and help young people be able to approach their teachers and approach people who work in their schools if they are being bullied. We're seeing advances in technology now and people being bullied over text messages, emails, through web pages, and I think government's role is to make sure that the schools have the tools to do the job in terms of making sure that young people and children can approach their teachers and approach the staff in the schools.
I used to teach, as I said before, kids across North East Wales in various schools, and it horrified me, because I'm also a parent, about bullying. I think bullying in society should not be allowed. It's a very complex issue. I think we've got a very strange society where we don't care about each other in many respects. And I think the very, very last straw is to be big brother and have everybody watching us all the time. I think it's a matter of educating people to have respect for each other. When you look at the street cred aspect of young people's lives, that's totally the opposite to what we in a caring society should be aiming for. It's very sad that perhaps one of the easiest ways is to stick a CCTV camera. I really think it's very sad. I speak as a magistrate as well, and somebody who's had a wealth of experience like the rest of us, and I think that we have to re-engage into a much more caring society. I'm not sure how we do that, but it's really overdue. There was a horrifying example of careless society in one of the Sunday papers. One of the journalists is writing about her mother having died as an older person in a hospital with a careless attitude. And I think we've got to really engage with each other and respect and give ourselves a modicum of care, because otherwise every step of the way that we take in our society will be recorded. And my God, that is quite frightening.
Okay, can you hear me at the back? Yeah. Bullying in schools. I actually have spoken about bullying. Homophobic bullying in the Assembly and at the Mardi Gras recently. And I think the first question you have to ask about bullying is who are the victims? And the victims are very often those who are recognised as being different from everybody else, and those who are recognised as being weak. And I think that the key to unravelling bullying is to embrace difference and bring about a cultural change. The vulnerable are always those who are bullied, and it takes very many forms now. I think that many of the answers about dealing with bullying are here in this room. It has to be peer-led. It has to be that young people don't any longer accept bullying as a social activity, which some people are trying to currently engage in with the text messaging and the use of new technology. Also, in terms of government, we have set clear criteria that schools have to implement. And I would put a challenge back to yourselves. If you have been a victim of bullying, ask your school or find somebody who can do it on your behalf to see their scheme where they say they are dealing with bullying. Then ask the next question. How many incidents of bullying have they on their books? And what have been the results of those being brought to their attention? Because it does, in schools, rest with the local authority. And I, unfortunately, had to go down this path because my son was bullied the most part of his school life. And it was a friend of his who said no more and brought it to the attention of the headmaster, even though I had tried many, many times to do it myself, that it stopped. And what I did as a parent was made those who had bullied him face him. And I made them answer the question why they thought it was acceptable to bully him. And did they not think, and the issue for him was wearing glasses, and did they not think that they were actually damaging him as an individual? And how did it make them feel better? And they couldn't answer the last question. So how does it make you feel better if you think that bullying is okay?
Thank you very much.